ಪರಮಾರ್ಥ ಸಾಧಿಕೆ ಶರಣ್ಯೇ ತ್ರಯಂಬಕೆ ದೇವಿ ನಾರಾಯಣಿ ನಮೋಸ್ತುತೆ. ಕಾವೇರಿ ಲೋಕಪಾವನಿ ಸಂಗಮ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರೇ ಸುಸ್ಥಿತೆ ಶ್ರೀಚಕ್ರ ರಾಜಸಹಿತೆ ಶ್ರೀ ನಿಮಿಷಾಂಬಾ ನಮೋಸ್ತುತೆ. ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓ ದ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಮದರ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಶ್ರೀ ನಿಮಿಷಾಂಬಾ, who is the sovereign queen of the three worlds, who stands at the confluence of the rivers Kaveri and Lokapavani, in front of the Shri Chakra, the myriad powers at your lotus feet, we humbly bow. Dhyanamoolam Guror Murtihi, Pujamoolam Guror Padam, Mantramoolam Guror Vakyam, Mokshamoolam Guror Krupa. In meditation, we see through experience the form of the self, that is our Atman. Through intense worship of the self, knowledge is revealed. When this knowledge is understood, the self reveals the holy word as the mantra itself. Repetition of the mantra invokes the grace of the self, revealing the path to liberation. Today, how we think and feel determines our actions, that decides the very course of our lives. Our thoughts and feelings make up our lives. Every word we speak and every act we perform originates from a thought or a feeling from deep within us. They determine how our lives seem good, bad, wonderful, beautiful, tragic, comic, pleasurable, sorrowful, or boring. It can even be joyous or blissful. If our thoughts could be changed, our thinking defined and refined and organized, then definitely we could change our lives for the better. So, my dear friends, always remember, what you think makes your life, what you feel makes your actions, and how you refine yourself, it'll change not only yours but other lives as well for the best. Meditation will redefine and reorganizes the forces in us, transforming us from ordinary human beings to extraordinary human beings. That is the fact of life. So, today, with Mother's grace, I was able to bring out this book on meditation. Basically, I didn't do anything. It was done by my guru, the mother, the Supreme Mother herself. So, any kind of ordinary speeches or anything that pertains to me is not me at all. It is my guru. So, that is how we say in spirituality, everything comes from the guru and it gets completely reorganized and refined in you so that it comes out, you blossom to your full. That is how we will experience many beautiful, wonderful moments that will not only last for days and months, but it will stretch into the years to come through meditation. So, meditation taps into our own source, the inner fount of energy called as the self or the soul itself. Before we understand how to transform our thoughts and feelings through meditation, let us see where they come from. They originate from the mind, which consists of several strands of thoughts. However, the mind is an extremely important tool that has been given to us. How we use our minds depends on different factors like our upbringing, education, profession, experience, karmic way of behaving, religious and cultural background, family background, so on and so forth. As long as the mind is focused, it is occupied only with whatever it has been doing. This is very important. It is common human experience within all of us that the mind is hardly ever still. In fact, it is like a generator, constantly turning thought after thought, generating something or the other deep within us. This is what we have to understand. That is how we tackle our inner feelings with the thought. If you take care of your thought, that means you have taken care of 80% of your life's actions and your life itself. Then, how do we come out of its mind and its qualities? This is very important. How do we come out of our mind and its qualities? To help us come out from this state, we have to first understand our very own soul and its powers. You have to take your life from mind-based to soul-based. This is very important. So, our soul is not bound by time or space, as you know. Most of you know. How do we do that? Understand? Come out of the mind concept. How do we do that? At least 10 minutes in the morning and 10 minutes in the evening. Try to spend your time with your own soul rather than allowing your mind to occupy every important sacred space inside you. That is very important. Why is it so? Because soul is not bound by time or space. It is even beyond birth or death. It has always existed and will always continue to exist. The body doesn't do that. That is very important for you to understand. Because of force of habit over a period of time, probably from many lifetimes, in case you believe about reincarnation, still let me tell you, you have to come out every day at least for 20 minutes or 15 minutes in the morning or 15 or 20 minutes in the evening, because you have to go and touch base with your soul. Very important. So, it is only the body that has a fixed lifespan for all of you, for all of us. It is subject to age and it finally dies. So, the body is always changing, constantly, consistently. This is what we have to remember. That is why when we look at our own photographs from the past 5 years or every 5 years, when we look back and see our own photographs, we see a lot of change ourselves externally, because the body is subject to change. The body, mind and everything has got a limited time space, because the senses are very normal and very limited. But if you look at our soul, it is infinite and never changing. It is ever present. It is omnipresent. So, scientifically, when you look at it, it is called as pure, infinite consciousness, but religiously, we call it as God Himself. This is the basic point. Today, in our age, in this era of 2012, we should understand we have to interpolate science and religion. If we are based on religion, automatically we are always outdated within the next day itself. There will always be somebody who will be denying the very existence of God. So, my dear friends, understand that we should always be soul-based, because we know this is something permanent. God takes up a form in the soul, but the pure infinite consciousness takes form everywhere. That same infinite consciousness is in you, is outside you, is in me, is outside of me, and it is there in each one of you. This is very important for you to remember. So if you think nanage ee devara mele nambike illa anta heladre yava devara melu nimage nambike irodu agatyavagi illa adare ninna shuddha atma parishuddha atma adara mele ninage nambike idare saaku ade ninna chetana ade ninna chaitanya idanna naavu motta modalu tilkolbeku Because we are always thinking God is in some form or the other. That is not the case. God is everywhere. If you understand God is omnipotent, if you understand God is omnipresent, and if you understand God is omniscient, then God is everywhere. God is everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. So, if you think you are sticking to one particular form of God, you are very wrong, my dear friend. God is everywhere. That is the meaning of the statement, omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. This is what we should understand. Since age catches up with our mind and intellect, we should always understand the soul through them. The reason is because we really cannot understand the soul through the mind and intellect. That is what right now we are doing. We are trying to catch God, that infinite, pure consciousness in our mind and intellect. Why? The soul is infinite and immortal. However, we can feel its presence and realize it through meditation. If you look at the mind and intellect, if you want to train it, you can really train it by attending a lot of educational courses. So much of courses we have in this world today, we can do it. But if you want to understand the soul, which is infinite and immortal, then you have to go through one and the only process called as meditation. For meditation, education is not very important. I am not telling you, don't misquote me. Education is very important for us to develop our mind and intellect. But if you want to have your peace of mind, my dear friend, understand, you require meditation. So, however we can feel and realize it through meditation. Meditation bypasses the mind, and meditation makes us feel the soul subtlety by removing all mental impurities and karmic effects. That is what meditation does to all of you. All mental impurities and karmic effects it will remove. As you meditate, you find very light, very peaceful in your life. You feel all kinds of problems which has been loaded onto you has unloaded now. Meditation unloads the mental baggage. It frees the mind and makes it extremely pure. So, since the beginning of our inner journey of meditation together, right now, from the past couple of hours, we have started the meditation together. I see a lot of interest in meditation. You want to understand what is peace. You want to understand what is life. You want to understand what is the beauty and the essence of your life. So, since the beginning of our inner journey of meditation together, the mind becomes soft, pure, and subtle. We start receiving and retaining the energy of the soul, and that flows from it during meditation. That means we understand meditation allows the energy of the soul to flow through your mind and intellect. This is very important for you to understand this.